Now I would like to give the floor to Madame Superi to present the Commission's priorities on a competitive digital union. Welcome.
So thank you indeed for inviting me to speak at your important event, which I think comes at a very special moment, because it is as we speak that we are really in the Commission and in the European Commission and including in DigiGrow, the DG for which I'm working. It's now that we are really looking deeply and intensively at how best we can accelerate the digital transition of our businesses and industries in order to make them more resilient and competitive, overcoming what has been a very difficult time, and so that our businesses and industries are better prepared to face the challenges of the future, which crucially includes digitalization. Now, the crisis in Europe overall is not completely behind us, and indeed there are important challenges ahead. At the same time, we also think that there are opportunities, as any crisis, this has been also an accelerator of trends. And indeed, one element that the past 2 years, close to 2 years, have shown to us is the vital importance of the digital transition for the resilience and the competitiveness of our industries. And we have all seen how digital solutions have allowed us to stay connected and to carry on doing business in spite of the many physical restrictions. Now, there are a number of businesses and the European businesses which have made a leap forward towards digitalization. However, we can see that there is still much untapped potential. And also we have observed that those companies that are pursuing and investing in digitalization are more likely to succeed than those who do not in our world. And this is in particular the case for SMEs, so the small and medium-sized enterprises, and for the more traditional less tech-savvy industries, which do need their our help. So we are very much focusing our efforts on the more traditional companies, and in particular on the smaller companies who need support. I think, useful to remind ourselves that the resources that this time in this financing programming period have been earmarked for the digitalization are quite significant. So if we take the whole amount of 1,800,000,000 of multi-annual financial framework plus the next generation EU, 20% of that total amount will have to be devoted to digital investments. So this is quite a remarkable, I think, I don't want to say a result, but at least a quite remarkable intention. However, we do think that public funding can only be one of the solutions. It's also pretty clear that private actors, private companies, businesses will have to invest. But also, there must be even more effective partnerships between the public and the private. So at least the three strands in terms of funding: the public, private, and public and private. And we do think that. Will also depend on the ability, but also the willingness of businesses to adopt new and innovative digital technologies rapidly, including in those industrial ecosystems. You know that we have identified 14 industrial ecosystems, and there are some which are clearly lagging behind. And in order to promote that further digitalization for those ecosystems that lag behind, we do think that we need to understand better the demands and the demands of the potential users of digital solutions. And again, we want to focus our efforts, especially on the smaller companies, on SMEs, and on those who are not necessarily digitally native. Very briefly, I will outline three points, which I hope will explain how we intend to support digitalization further. So the first point relates to our policy initiatives. As you, I'm sure you know, we have in the Commission adopted recently a so-called digital compass, which is setting targets for digitalizing Europe on four strands: infrastructure, so digital infrastructure, skills, crucially, as you also mentioned. The public administration is the third strand, and the fourth one is industry and businesses. And to turn these targets or these goals, so let's say, into reality, we have set out in our recent industrial strategy update a way to assist our industrial ecosystems concretely on this path towards digital transformation. This brings me to my second strand, which relates to what we call digital transformation pathways. What is it? So we are actually working on, together with all industrial ecosystems, we are working on roadmaps that should help us to gain a better understanding of the individual industrial ecosystem's needs. So the first step is to identify the needs. The second one is to identify what are the key obstacles on the way to achieve more digital opportunities. The third element is the tools that are available to overcome those obstacles. And the last but not least element is actions. So it's plans. So we want to devise and identify concrete actions per industrial ecosystem meant to boost digitalization. And how do we want to do this? We want to do this in a in a hopefully non-bureaucratic way, but rather in a bottom-up and co-creation process, together with industry, but also together with public bodies, research and development, the research and development community, social partners, and also other stakeholders. So industry will be closely involved and should be ready to take ownership of these commitments. And as I was saying, the result will have to be a tailored, actionable plan to accompany, actually it's the twin transition, because there is digitalization and at the same time also the sustainability one. And to do so in this process, we want to be concrete, we have to be granular, and I would like to stress again, industry must be involved and fully behind this process, knowing that there will be no one fits all solution, so there will have to be tailored solution per industrial ecosystem. And this leads briefly to my third strand. So just to give you a flavor of what could be, in our view, some examples of transformative initiatives in the digital field, let me give you two. The first relates to data. This is also something you mentioned before. So we want to work together with industry on establishing so-called data spaces, which should facilitate the collection and the sharing of data. We will start with the tourism ecosystem, which was one of the most hit, as you know, by the crisis, but we will continue also with other industries, and better use of data is crucial for the future to have a more prospective and strategic industrial challenges. So one example is data spaces. Another example could be the development of local platforms, matching demand and supply for the circular economy, for example, or for more efficient use of goods. And these platforms could significantly increase efficiency of local, in particular, businesses. One example where these local platforms are proving to be very interesting is the construction industrial ecosystem, where, for example, these platforms could be used to sell, and there are already some, but we need to develop that further to allow selling or giving away, for example, material leftovers, or to allow sharing rent or lease materials and equipment, just to make an example. So we estimate that the unlocked potential of an increase in productivity in the relevant ecosystems through the use of platforms could be huge, with some studies, preliminary studies, suggesting that it could reach up to 15 billion per year. So I think I will stop here, and not to be too long. I hope I was able to give you an overview of what we are trying to do to enhance digitalization further. Of course, there are a lot of also of regulatory initiatives, artificial intelligence, data act to come, digital services act, digital market act. But if there are questions, I will be happy to reply. Thank you again for the opportunity to intervene today. Oh, that's so kind. Thank you.
Madam Supervisor, thank you so much for your insights. We will have questions after the speeches.